Hello. as you can see, this was not very rehearsed. I just figured we'd do a little demo of like, you know, let's get some hardware going on Nostr. So the name of this project is SATSLINK, and I'm going to get into it. What's going on is all the phones are owned, right? We don't have secure private hardware, and that's pretty abhorrent. I mean, like your iPhone and your Android phones, they can be remotely accessed. You have no privacy in them, and we don't really have diversity in this space. So the comms are bound. What we need to do is free the comms, right? So we need devices so that we can communicate privately and experiment in a way that you choose who can see what you're doing. It's very important. So how do you free the comms, right? I mean, like, we can't just go and start a new cell phone company that makes a new cell phone device. Cell phones are amazing. They are the most complex, incredible advancement that we have right now in consumer electronics. So I can't make you a cell phone, but we can start somewhere, right? We don't simply give up on it and don't create something. So we've leveraged the mechanical design and some of the stuff that we were doing for Bitcoin hardware wallets, the cold card, and we went out there and we've decided to find something affordable as a technology platform and create something that is for hackers. Right now, this is a product for the nerds. Because most technology really starts with like hackers playing with it, the military playing with it, or porn. And we need to start somewhere there. And we looked around what was available for people to have a portable device that they can use for communication that is also hackable, has some sort of like capacity of security, and you would fit in your pocket, has a battery and a few other things. So you have Arduinos, you have ham radios, you know, some of us like those. You know, you have like your game platforms, and then you have like the hardware wallets that are like super secure, some less secure. And we wanted to create something sort of like in the middle as a playground for hackers, because creating like portable hardware is not simple, right? So most makers out there, they can buy their awesome like little ESP32 boards, but they can't create a wrapper, they can't do battery management, they can't like add a lot of other things like secure elements on it, and we can. So we figured we expose some of the stuff that we do for us to play in the Nostr space and other forms of comms in a P2P sort of capacity. So what do we think like people are going to do with this you know, Nostr signing devices, mesh communications. We're still trying to figure out if you're going to have a relay on it or not. But the devices can talk to each other. They can talk to the internet. You can, you know, have password managers. You can do Bitcoin transaction coordination. It really is like a small, very powerful general purpose platform. So you can do whatever really you want. So today I just wanted to demo a very quick P2P communication on this device. My hope is that it sort of like inspires people to go out there and try to create embedded software that does some of this stuff. And hopefully they will build for that, ESP32, and they can build for these devices. So we have a little demo. I have my assistant here today. Okay. So let's. He's unnamed. He created Facebook. Here, the power button. There you go. So we have two little devices turned on. They are unpaired. These guys don't hold memory yet, so like there's nothing saved on them except for the OS that we created. So do you wanna chat? So we're gonna press chat, select chat. There we go. So Mr. Jack here is typing something, and look at that, it shows up right here. Hey. And I send that, and it shows up over there. Look at that. What is he writing? Help. Anyways, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. So this is a little protocol called ESP Now. And ESP Now leverages the Wi-Fi modem. So your Wi-Fi radio is being leveraged for you to send information back and forth between these devices without any pairing. It's multicast, right? So we could have 50 devices here. We could all be chatting to each other. And we can encrypt the data. We can use it to transport Nostr envelopes. And we think that like people are going to be using for some of those things. And these devices, they will have a secure element. And we found a open secure element that it's a little bit hard to use, so we're going to do some pre-programming for you. And you can hold your NSECs there, for example, right? You can do some of the very high security stuff in a very cheap, affordable platform so that, you know, you can go in a protest and everybody can talk to each other. And, you know, the Fed FUDs can't really listen to what you're saying. It's pretty cool. So that's SATSLINKs for you guys. I hope people enjoy it. We hope to ship it soon. But the cool thing is, because this is an open platform, ESP32, you can go right now, buy a ESP32 board on the internet if you're a developer, start targeting code to that, and then when you get your SATSLINK, you can sort of start loading some of that code in. And you can take it out. And SATSLINK, ideally, could talk to any other ESP32 module product platforms out there. You're not sort of contained in this space. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much. Yeah, sure. If anybody has any questions, just mic is over there.
Hey, just a comment. Hi, this is Lottie again. I just want to say I really love the fact that it's built like a Game Boy.
Yes.
Like it's this is great. And also, can we have this deck?
Sorry?
Can we have the deck? Is that going to be somewhere publicly?
Yeah. I'll put it online. Awesome. Yeah, I'll definitely put it online.
Thank you.
Do you have a domain?
Absolutely. It's satslink.com. Like, oh. Yeah, domain is something that we have.
All the domains.
Other questions, comments from the audience? You have one?
Do you have a Nostr account for CoinGuide or SatsLink?
Not yet. I'm waiting for key rotation.
Okay.
You know, you can't as a brand.
Pablo.
Yeah, come
Pablo,
on.
Pablo, fix this.
Pablo, fix this.
Last few questions here.
So, funny you ask. This is because we leverage Q1, a mechanical design for this. He accelerated things further. So, hopefully, end of the year, early next year, should be out. No. Yeah, like early in the year. Yeah, early next year, yeah. Christmas is almost here, man. Vendors move too slow. You know, it's the plastics people.
Over here, Enrique, question. I see an evolution happening here from your earlier devices to now. What is your vision for like a final form of what this could become?
So that's a great question. We really don't know what people want to build. And so we did leverage the mechanicals of one product, right? Just so we have something that is affordable for people to play with. And the hope is that people will inform us like what they want to do with this. And you know, a second version would hopefully reflect that, right? Does it need to be smaller? Does it need to be bigger? Does it need something else? And we're going to learn a lot. So this kind of a shape and sort of mechanical. It's very conducive for typing, right? It's a nice little QWERTY keyboard there. We think that this should be general purpose enough for you to create and then sort of like, and then we can specialize and maybe, I don't know, make this into, a little sort of, you know, maybe it's just like a token that touches something and signs an NSAC. But first we need something for people to develop on.